And we have pushed the button to go live. I see it over on Restream. And let's see. Oh, yep. Looks like YouTube is receiving our content. Now, let's see if Twitch. Oh, yeah. Twitch has got us. Look at that. Then I'm going to say we're officially live. Welcome, everybody. Happy Monday. Adam Patrick Murray here with PC World. I'm joined on the line by Willis Lai.
Hello, Willis. Hello.
Are you ready to finish some fights?
Psst, ready.
Oh.
Oh, hey.
Oh, we have a wild Elena appears. Hello, Elena. Happy
Hello.
Monday.
Happy Monday. I'm going to be lurking, watching, judging.
Hey, hang out. Elena's going to do a couple things on the back end while we... play a couple levels, and hopefully she can hop in when she can. So yeah, let's get over to the game. Last time we had some technical difficulties. Whoops, no. But this time I think we got them ironed out. Both Willis and I did some hardcore troubleshooting.
Oh yeah.
Hardcore. Yeah, let's start it up. Eskamonster, what's going on? Eek44, hello, and Nuta Lucian, hello. How's everybody's Monday going? TGREXE is over on Twitch, hello. And yes, I guess you're first. Cool. Oh, and now my audio is back loud again, we'll see.
Ooh.
Let me know if the volume mix is good on everybody's end. Willis is using the new mic.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man, Eskamonster, you're always giving us money. Thank you. 20
Thank you.
Danish krones. Don't judge you so hard. I ain't judging. I ain't judging at all. Oh, Dennis Siberian, friend of the show. Oh, don't judge us. Oh, okay, got it. Yeah, we would never judge you, Eskamonster.
It's an innate habit. I do my best to control it.
Alright, yeah. Now the audio is a little loud, so I'm going to...
Yeah.
There we go. Turn it down. Hopefully it's not too bad. But yeah, hello, Dennis, friend of the show. Oh, and now maybe the audio is too quiet. Okay, let me... find a little spot in the corner. All right, don't die. Cover me.
All right.
Let's go to 30. Why don't we try that? Save. There we go. Okay. Doesn't sound too bad.
Yay!
Anyway, Dennis. Oh, Shannon Knight. Hello. Yes, this game is awesome. I'm glad you agree. Dennis was asking when we can get back into the studio. So if you've seen Elena's latest case unboxing, should we have another one in the pipeline too? Elena was able to go in and film, and then San Francisco got put back on the essential workers only list. So we are not going back into the studio anytime soon, unfortunately. So yeah. That's where we stand. It's been a long, hard road,
but
can't complain too much.
We are trying to figure out something so that I can do video from home.
Yeah, we want Elena to be able to... I'm down, by the way. Oh, okay, I'm back.
Yep, okay.
Not only do we want Elena to be able to do some cool video, we want to do some builds. I mean, it's been a while since we did a proper build, and we're itching to do it. There we go. Okay, grenade planted. Back up.
Oh.
Oh, sorry.
I didn't see you plant that grenade.
Well, that's the first and not last time I killed my teammate. So.
Adam.
Oh, and you're back.
I'm back. Yeah.
Only this time it wasn't on purpose.
It wasn't on purpose. Also, look out in the water. Do you see that dropship in the water, Willis?
Oh, yeah.
That is weird. That's a weird glitch. That's funny. That's funny. All right, well, it's our favorite time. Warthog time.
Let's do this. Hold on a second. Get out. All right.
Man, it's weird. It's kind of quiet again.
Banshees.
Oh, goodness.
Oh, boy.
I stopped to adjust my headset. And I shouldn't have done that. So... Right. Yeah, last time we were having technical trouble, but it was after we had talked about the Halo reveal of Halo Infinite. And to my surprise, there's a lot of people who are angry on the internet about Halo, how Halo Infinite looks, including
really,
our coworker Luis does not like the look of the new Halo. Says it looks last gen.
I finally saw you guys do that roll of the Warthog.
I mean, yeah, I got to show off, you know. Sorry. Oops. No, we're good.
Oh, it was like me last night playing Halo 2 with Lave, and I was like, I can't remember how to do the actual fancier maneuvers, aerial maneuvers in this Banshee. And so my friend Joel, who drops into my stream chat sometimes, he's like, oh, you press this button combination. So I just started doing it back-to-back-to-back, like several loops.
Uh-huh.
And he like turns and looks at his screen because, you know, it's on a delay. And he's like, what is happening? Is your game glitching out? I said, no, I'm following your instructions.
But offline, you alluded to you beat Halo 2 yesterday with Leif on your personal channel?
No.
Oh, no.
No, so these problems that you are having yesterday still was plaguing, you know, even our connection. We were having some problems last night, and we got like maybe 2/3 of the way, almost done with the final mission in Halo 2.
Uh-huh.
And then it just hard locked and booted us out. So we'll have to redo that whole thing again.
Wow.
Yeah,
oh,
I mean,
I'm
that
dead.
Happened.
I'm dead.
That used to happen on Master Chief Collection a lot in the early days when it first launched on Xbox One. It was a complete pain in the butt. Okay. And
let's get back in.
I had to play the Maw in Combat Evolved like 3 times before I could get the stupid achievement to pop for me. That's one of the reasons why. When I was playing, I think on my personal stream, I had people in my chat saying like, you're doing pretty well, and I was like, that's muscle memory at this point. It's not an indicator of actual skill.
We'll
get those towers up there.
Oh. Yeah, sorry. Oh, nope. Oh, that was lucky.
Oh,
well,
no.
You know, hey, you know, that's better than nothing. Yeah, no, actually, let's get in. We still need it. All right. So, Elena, I don't know if you're in the chat as well, but Drew has a question that might be up your alley. Drew Nielsen is asking, I want to buy a desktop PC right now. Is it possible to buy one that will match the performance of the Xbox Series X? Match, not simply near it, and at what cost? Actually, you know what? I think we can go deep in here.
Okay. Hold on.
Honestly, I think at this point, without knowing actual specifics, like direct detailed specifics of the hardware in the Series X, I can't actually tell you what that is yet.
Oh,
it is definitely something that's on my radar for what I want to cover as we get that information. I'm hoping we get that information in August, because as we all know, like this past July, you know, game show that they did was focused solely on the games we're supposed to be looking forward to.
Right, I'm coming back.
My impression is that the August, whatever they were going to do in August, I guess made for Gamescom, we'll get much more of a detailed look at the hardware.
Yeah.
And then finally, I can start figuring out what that build would look like.
I will say
it's a question I want to answer for myself, so it's definitely on my radar.
I will say, but it's not going to be out of the realm of possibility. I mean, the Xbox Series X, whatever hardware is in there, is not going to be above what you can make in a gaming PC. So, I mean, you could ballpark it and err on the side of just pure power.
The thing is that the hard part of it is the one-to-one, right?
Yeah. Well,
because
sorry. All right, I don't think we can fit it.
You know, even with the Xbox One X, when we tried to do a one for one, we couldn't actually do it for the Blu-ray side of things, all the components possible, because on PC there is weirdness, or at the time there was weirdness around what specific motherboards and motherboard and CPU combination that would support the DRM for 4K Blu-ray.
I'm still down.
But it was ridiculous. Okay, it inflated the cost of the build dramatically. Well,
and the hardware itself, wasn't it just the drive itself like $400?
No, the drive wasn't quite that expensive.
Oh, really? Okay.
But it just made it more difficult. And then on top of that, there was no one-to-one for the amount of VRAM for the graphics, you know? So you could say that it was closely equivalent to an RX 580, but the RX 580 capped out at 8 gigs of VRAM.
Oh, nice shot.
Excuse me, my cat is knocking on the door. I'll be right back.
No, please do what you gotta do. Yeah, I mean, it's... So, Drew, Are you primarily just a gamer? Do you care about Blu-ray? I would be curious, you know, to hear if you care about that or not, because, I mean, that's gonna be a problem. But then again, on the PC, I mean, you're mostly getting digital anyway, so it's not like you have to worry about Blu-ray when it comes to the games themselves, the discs. Oh, sorry, Willis.
I'm actually hoping that they do discless version of the Series X, so then I can just compare our build against that and not have to worry about the Blu-ray drive this time around.
Yes.
Make my life a lot easier.
I mean, but did people really give us crap for not including it in the last one?
Oh my goodness, you can't tell console gamers that this is a comparison with their with their console and not have it actually match. Oh no.
Well, no, but that I mean, like, I mean, there's always going to be, you know, like the whatever hardcore crowd. I'm talking about like actual people who are like, oh, you know what? Like, I still want
Willis
a PC.
Behind?
Well, you know, what? Just for a second, he snapped back. you know, there's always going to be people who are not happy with it. I'm not talking about them. I'm talking about somebody like Drew. It sounds like Drew, I'm down still.
Okay.
You know, wants to get a PC that matches it so that he's safe. But, you know, it doesn't sound like he's somebody who's going to be like, well, no matter what, the Xbox is going to be better.
I wasn't talking about Drew specifically. I was just saying that you asked me about the last build in general.
Yeah.
And if we ran into trouble. I mean, I got flack for the fact that I didn't include the cost of a mouse and keyboard.
How are you going to play without that, Elena?
Well, I mean, and a headphone. I mean, you know, anyway. But Drew does say he definitely cares about Blu-ray. He has an Xbox One S right now and plan on keeping it, but since he needs a desktop, he's considering switching to the PC for gaming gradually. The Blu-ray part's always going to be the hard part.
Blu-ray is going to be the hard part if you want to switch wholesale, but if you're willing to keep the Xbox One S around in your living room so that you can watch, you know, 4K Blu-ray there, then you should have no problems replicating the basic, you know, hardware, the core hardware in the Series X for at least a comparable experience, if not better, honestly. So it's a question I definitely want to answer when the time comes.
Yeah.
Just waiting for better specs, or sorry, better details for specs.
But, I mean, either way, I do think, you know, like the Xbox Series X is definitely going to be, you know, a very powerful console, but you're still going to be able to get a good PC experience if you're just doing digital games, you know, and not worrying about the Blu-ray part.
Honestly, at this point, and don't nobody tell Gordon I said this, which means everyone's going to tell Gordon I said this. I've been playing Control, and I have to say that the load times on Xbox, and I have a Xbox One X, so that's, you know, the best that's available currently. The load times annoy me, and every single time I'm waiting after I inevitably die again because I did something stupid.
Wait, on PC or console?
On console, right? The load times take forever. So I've been thinking to myself, God, I should have bought this game for PC. I should have bought this game for PC.
Yeah, I mean, it's long load times even on the PC too. I mean, with an SSD, yeah, it's not like it's not super like pop in and out. I remember it being like, oh boy, this is still taking a while.
It's driving me batty.
Yeah.
Like,
I mean, it's obviously better on PC, but
it just feels so punitive, you know, where it's like you suck at this game, so now you have to wait even longer to get back into it. And it's like, ah, oh, come on, guys.
Yeah. I feel like they showed that in Digital Foundry, how long it was. So I don't remember like the direct comparison, but yeah, I mean, either way, console's worse.
Oops, I jumped out on an
accident. Don't jump out, Willis. We need you.
I forgot this can't swim in Halo.
Well, I died too. Also, Dennis has a good question. Do we think that the criticism towards Halo Infinite is due to the trailer looking like the next Far Cry clone set in the Halo universe? I would actually say no. I would say it's people who don't realize that Halo has always had a certain like style. Like, Halo's never gone for like a Call of Duty realism kind of look. Like, it's always been pretty hyper stylized. So I think people, you know, and most of the criticism, I think, is from a lot of people just like being like, well, I wish it was, you know, I wish it looked even better. It's like, well, I mean, to a certain degree, that's the style, you know, they're not going for realism. But then also, I think a lot of people, or at least I also heard people say the same thing, not necessarily around Halo specifically, but be like, hey, why are they not really showing off, like, this is the only on the power of the Xbox Series X, you know? Like, it looks like a game that can be played on an Xbox One X right now, which is probably true. I mean, they're building it for both. But, yeah, I think people also want justification for getting a whole new box. And it, you know, without the developer sitting down and being like, well, look, this, and this can only be achieved with the Xbox Series X. It's hard to tell from just a gameplay demo. I mean, either way they... Oh, I'm down. Either way, they just want to sell the game. Oh, man. Eek, 45 Danish krones. Thank you.
Oh, thank
Gaming
you.
On their Xbox 360 is still good. No new for me. Nice. Hey, 360. It was a hell of a machine.
I still have a 360. I'm
down, by the way.
Yeah, let me see if I can settle this. There it is.
I can literally see nothing but green.
Nothing but green? Oh, okay.
Yeah, I think I'm in the water.
Okay, I think I can set my craft down.
Oh gosh, that is quite a death.
Yeah, I was just plummeting with it attached to my backside.
On fire.
Uh-oh, Dennis has a food and alcohol question coming up.
That's fair. It's a game stream.
I look forward to it.
Oh, I love...
All right, I'm back.
Okay.
So, Anthony, I'm similar to you, actually. I have Xbox, PS4, and PC, but I still skew more towards Xbox.
I think we're supposed to go in here, no?
Yeah. I don't know.
Oh,
I just
no, I guess
found
not.
A safe way.
Oh, wait, no, the checkpoint hit, so...
Oh.
Oh, okay. I'll hop on. Maybe it's the next little area.
Is it opening? I hear something opening.
Yeah. Is it? No, I don't think it is. So if you hit B, that descends.
B?
Yeah.
B?
Yeah.
Oh.
So A ascends and B descends.
Okay.
And Drew's saying, wait, I thought Microsoft already announced the specifications for the Series X. They kind of did. It wasn't a straight dump like, hey, here's exactly what parts, how many cores, you know, like what... speeds and feeds for everything.
They
did say
cores.
How many cores. Yes,
they have said cores.
They did talk about clock speeds too, actually.
Yes, but they haven't talked much about the graphic side of things, right? And so that's what we're really waiting for. Like, what kind of GPUs really running in here? How are they achieving, you know, ray tracing? How much ray tracing should we expect to see in games? I don't think... Have they mentioned RAM speeds? I don't think they've mentioned it yet for this go-around.
I can't remember.
So those are the kind of details that I'm waiting on still.
Well, I mean, especially since we're trying to do a, you know, a straight comparison, you know. I mean, so yeah, you can build a PC that's gonna be in the ballpark. Wait, weren't we just here? No.
No.
Wait, is this the same? No. Okay.
No. It's not. Oh boy. Crap. Oh boy.
Those things.
I'm dead. Oh.
I'm backing up. Retreat. Tactical retreat. Back. You're back? Okay, cool.
I'm back.
All right. I'm going to circle around to the left if you can keep him engaged on the front.
Okay.
Oh, crap.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, are you down again?
I'm dead. Yeah.
Okay, tactical retreat again. Oh. Can't jump my way out of there. Yes, and we're estimating that the details are going to be further fleshed out around the August time frame. I mean, they got to tell us at some point, so. Yeah, it's a difference between being in the ballpark and being, you know, like, hey, you know what? This is exactly what you're probably going to get. It's never going to be one-to-one, but we can at least get pretty damn close. Nice. Yeah, it's weird. What was it? Was it Forza? They did mention the Forza demo, or not demo, but trailer that they showed, whatever, had ray tracing enabled, but they didn't say, like, what implementation, you know, what it was doing. Ray tracing right now can mean a lot of things. Shadows, reflections, audio, path tracing.
I'm not sure if, Adam, you were specifically addressing Drew's question about these details being announced in August when you mentioned the August thing.
Yeah.
I would just add to what you said that we expect that we'll hear about it. We are not certain we'll hear about it.
Yeah, exactly. We do not have insider knowledge.
We don't for this particular thing.
Oh, I'm dead.
Not that I have insider knowledge for much of anything. But for the timing in August, if I were to guess what it would be, I would put it around the Gamescom time frame.
Cool.
So more like mid to late August.
Hit the switch, Chief, and the barrier will fall.
Alright.
Oh, yes.
Oh.
The flood has shown up again.
No, not the floods.
Yep.
Oh, no.
I know you're excited. Contain your excitement, Willis.
Help. Oh, boy.
Oh, no, I'm out.
Oh, man. I missed these guys. Not.
You missed every single hairy little one of them. Oh, no. I'm double out of weapons. I got nothing. Oh no, I don't want this thing. Oh wait, there we go. Wait, where'd it go? There we go. I'll take that. Thank you. Oops, sorry.
Okay.
Jump! Nice. Wee! Wee! Have you ever done that in an elevator where you like jumped as it's going down and you just like hung in midair?
Yeah, not a good idea.
What? You never have?
I've done it once.
Oh, look, a hammer.
I got stuck in an elevator one time, and I'm not while doing, you know, jumping around, but I wouldn't want to mess with an elevator.
Actually, I think I know this story. Or maybe that was Dan. Dan had an elevator story, too.
Yeah.
It was a wedding, revolving a wedding. Was that you?
Oh, yeah, that was me.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I was filming a wedding. I was at the bride and groom's house, just... you know, getting ready, and then when we're about to head over to the reception, the couple, the family, basically the mom and dad and grandma, you know, we were all in the elevator, and it was a tiny elevator, and this was the one in I think close to your area. I told you, Adam.
Yep.
And the elevator got stuck, and we were there for like almost maybe 30, 45 minutes or so, waiting for a fire department to come save us. Yeah, grandma wasn't feeling well, so she might have been a bit claustrophobic. So I had to offer my backpack for her to just sit on it, because she was just kind of on the verge of fainting. And then after a while, finally, firefighters, thank goodness, came saving the day.
And we were out. Want to take the tank?
Oh, yeah. Nice. I can do that.
I'll have somebody get on the gun here. There we go. Cool. I used to do the thing where it'd be halfway between a floor, and then I would, like, pull open the doors so you could see the wall as it scrolls by.
Why? Why, Adam? Why would you do that?
I don't know. Sometimes you find
Adam.
Hidden messages.
That is like the most specific Adam thing I have heard this week so far.
It's only Monday.
I expect that there could be more. But that was a very classic Adam thing to hear.
Oh, no. Adam. No. No. I went off the edge.
No.
Whoops. Oopsie. All right, I'm back.
All right. Can you ride on this thing?
On the other side? I thought I could. I really thought I could. Oh, here, I can operate the turret. There we go.
Oh, nice.
Nice. Tag team.
Yeah.
Also, I can't remember if I told both of you or not, but I kind of cheated on us over the weekend and played some Halo 3 multiplayer. After the fun I had.
Oh my god! You said that as you were dying, like as you guys were flying off the cliff, and I was like, "Is this some weird, crazy drama movie that I am gonna feel bad about for hours after that? You felt so guilty about cheating on somebody
I drove off the cliff.
Did a murder suicide?
Yeah.
Oh my god, Adam.
Well, I mean, I had so much fun doing the multiplayer. Last Thursday that I was like, you know what, I kind of feel like doing this on my day off, so I played a little bit. I didn't play a ton. Oh no. Yeah, there you go. We're good. We're good. Push forward.
There's a Wraith somewhere.
Yep, I see him. Yeah, he's down. The music.
Oh,
right over our head.
Yeah, right.
Nice.
Over.
Don't stop. Keep going.
Yeah, no.
Never stop. Hornets inbound.
Hornets.
Nice. Yeah. Why don't you
supposed to ride on?
You keep taking the tank. I'm gonna take one of these.
Okay.
Oops. Nope. I'm gonna drive it. Thank you. Oh, yeah, because there's these big guys. Scarabs, that's what they're.
Oh.
Let's focus on the let's focus on the left one first.
Left one. Oh boy.
Wait, wasn't B descend? I thought it was.
I'm on fire.
Oh, I guess it's the bumpers that ascend and descend. Oh, okay, it's down. You focus on the other one. I'm gonna hop in this one. Ah, come on. What are you doing? Okay.
I'm dead.
I'm dead too.
Oh, boy.
That was not my finest moment. Let's do this again. One more for the team. Repeat, two scarabs. All right. Actually, you know what? I'm going to take these top guns out first.
All right.
One of them's down. All right. Oh no, I'm dead.
Oh no.
I'm falling comically.
Uh-oh.
Dennis, I do not have experience making moonshine or homemade brews.
Moonshine.
I do have experience drinking them.
Can't that stuff make you go blind if it's done wrong?
I mean, in this day and age, the definition of moonshine is pretty fast and loose, so you can have stuff that's like not that bad. There's moonshine as in people are making things, you know, secretly and not adhere. Oh no, I'm got out again. Jesus.
You're out again? Reckless.
Yeah. Whoops.
Oh.
Oh no, I'm down on the ground.
Are you all playing on heroic?
We're on heroic, yeah.
Oh my goodness.
I'm just a bad driver.
You want a warthog?
No, it's fine.
Oh no.
But yeah, there was a place in Austin that was called Moonshine something. I can't remember the name of it, but it was awesome. They had some really, really good moonshine. Oh no, it's down, but it's... Oh no! Wow!
Oh no, I'm dead.
I'm dead too.
Uh-huh. Oh boy.
Alright, team. Let's regroup. We can do this. I've got faith in us. God, what was it called? It was called Moonshine something. But it was fun. The last time I got to go was when the last time I went to South by Southwest. That was a pretty good time. Yeah, so there's like the illegal moonshine, like, oh, you're doing stuff that you're not supposed to be doing, like, you better watch out, somebody can go blind. But there is like an actual classification of moonshine that is regulated. You can still call it moonshine, but it's safe for consumption. I'm just doing a do-si-do on this one.
Same here.
Circle strafing. I guess I can't shoot its face. There we go. Okay, it's down. All right. Let's land. Nope. Let's land on it. Come on, Adam. There we go.
All right, I think I took it down.
All right, I'm about to take the other one down. Yep. Wait, did I get it? There we go. Okay, back in the vehicle, take off. You got the other one? Oh, no, it's still up.
All right.
Nope, it's still up. So when it's down on the ground, you got to go to the backside and hit that.
The
shield's still up. I'm shooting at it.
All right.
There we go. Okay, it's down. Now it just needs to explode. Right in there. Yippee-ki-yay. Willis Lai.
Nice.
Yippee-ki-yay. Alright, kill the Striders? Is that what she said?
Striders?
Stop truth from firing the rings. Oh, that's our guy. Whoops. Sorry. Alright. I think we're supposed to... Oh, okay, there we go. If only we had more time! Alright. Nice. Oh,
what? What? Why? It just closed the door on me. What's going on?
No, you're back.
Right, I got it. Oh, boy.
Okay, okay. Our enemies what do we got? Around us, we tread the blessed path. In a moment, I will light the rings, and all who believe shall be saved. Also, Drew, if you're still here, we will be definitely talking about the specs of the Xbox Series X and PS5 when they're laid out in full. On the Full Nerd, if you watch or listen to the Full Nerd podcast, we always like to break it down there. So,
come on. Impress me. Stop, you imbecile! He wants you to kill him. I prefer that.
Oh.
Oh. Nice.
nice entrance, grand entrance.
Wrecking the party.
Johnson. Oh. Sound off.
Get out of here.
Not without you.
Your delay.
She's here to save the day.
One of you will light the ring. You cannot hope to kill.
Ooh, badass.
Nice. Can she do it?
Now.
Oh. Oh no.
No.
No. Oh.
Damn. It was all in vain.
Your forefathers wisely set aside their compassion, steeled themselves for what needed to be done. I see now why they left you behind. You gods must be strong.
Oh no. Is she dead?
Oh, she's dead.
That's sad.
Do not shoot, but listen. Let me lead you safely to our foe.
I can talk?
Only you can
hold. Don't underestimate the flood.
Ah!
Now they're on our side.
What?
What? Mind
twist.
Blown. Halo 3.
Twist.
Thank goodness we don't have to fight them. They're on our side. Just hang back, Willis. Just watch. Just watch the carnage.
Oh, whoops. I don't think we can really hang back.
I fell off the edge. Good job, Adam. Yep.
Yeah. This makes me feel slightly better about all the dumb things that I do when I'm playing.
Oh, I'm dead. Oh, I got hit.
Nice.
Also, Adam, Drew is still with us, hanging out with us.
Nice. Drew's the man. If he is a man or a woman. Nice. Right through the door to their doom. Turret time.
Turret time.
How could I have known the parasite would follow? Undoubtedly, this is the heretic doing.
The heretic. Nice, nice. Nice.
So I'm watching the little floods just like swarming at the
I know, it's nice, brute. Right? It's nice when we don't have to deal with it.
I know. Oh, I'm dead too. Ah, man.
Alright, I'll back up. Tactical retreat. Flood, take over.
Oh! I spawned on an open area and I just fell, right? Down. Nice. What?
I'm gonna jump through the halo here. There we go. Woo-hoo. Oh, wow. Right to the chin. Oh, wow, I'm dead.
Oh, boy. Okay.
Okay, I'm back. All right. We need to do some tactical sniping. Nice. Take the hammer, man.
Take the hammer. All right, taking the hammer.
So far, we are on the path that I must stray.
Well, thank you, Drew. You don't have to do that. It's always appreciated, but you never feel like you have to.
Oh, yeah, no. We just do these streams to hang out and have fun, and it's always cool to have people join us, you know?
Yeah.
So, your company is already great. Otherwise, it's just the three of us talking to each other.
I mean, you know, which we would have done anyway.
which nicely summarizes my life experiences while streaming. I actually tried. I think, did I tell you, Adam? I tried my first solo stream.
Yeah.
This weekend. So I'm going to do a video to finally wrap up the Twitch streaming PC series since I finally have fulfilled all the requirements.
You fulfilled your mission of being Twitch stardom.
My project. But it's actually quite stressful because I'm so used to just being on these streams hanging out with people that I know are here to hang out with us. And then suddenly it's like, oh no, I have like randos like dropping in and I feel like I have to entertain them. And
you must entertain.
Oh no, she really is dead. Dang it.
I shall become a god.
That the whole lineage is gone. Both her dad and her are gone. That's sad.
No.
But yeah, that was stressful. I was like, I have to keep talking. I don't know how to keep talking. I normally play games being very quiet and only occasionally talking out loud.
It's kind of like me too. Oh.
You must be silenced.
Whoa! You must be silenced.
Oh no. And he was. Thank you, Eek44 gave us 19 more Danish krones with a cool sticker. Cool.
Thank you.
It's a pear. I love pears.
Is it a pear?
Looks like it.
It's a cool pear.
Yeah, it's got a little workout band.
Oh.
I feel like anybody who says that they're going to become a god is not necessarily a good candidate for becoming a god.
Yeah, I usually try not to say it, so. Because I know I'm not a good candidate.
Wait, usually?
I usually try not to.
What are the instances that you would say it?
I mean, if I had the choice to become a vampire, I totally would. And live forever? Yeah, I could totally do it. So in
but
some
that's
forms,
not a
that's
god.
A god. Well, I mean...
That's not a god.
Immortal.
God requires, like,
right?
like omnipotent and omniscience and all those omni-type words.
I would say that that's a very narrow definition of god. You know, in your you know, San Francisco lifestyle.
Look, I was raised with a specific specific type of god in my consciousness in terms of what was the prevailing thing in Western civilization. Okay?
A white man. Yep. Guess what?
I didn't go there. I want to say that. I want to have the record show that you went there.
Yeah, I'm just saying. Alanis Morissette made a song about, you know, God couldn't be any of us. Or was that Alanis Morissette? I don't know. What if God was one of... No, that's not Alanis Morissette. Anyway, we're back to the flood, not on our side anymore. That was short-lived. Man. Yeah.
I know.
You're like, wait, hold up.
I gotta get my hopes up.
Can we go back there? Oh, you know what? I want that. Thank you. I will take it. That wasn't Jewel, was it? No. No, it's not Jewel. Oh, okay, well now we got at least have Guilty Spark 343 with a little bit of backup. Don't shoot the flying robots.
Oh yeah.
They're on our side.
Oh gosh, I don't know who's enemy and who's foe now.
I know, or right?
Who's ally, who's foe.
I mean, listen, also at the time, Willis, everyone thought this was going to be the last Halo, you know? This is Halo 3. It's the end of the trilogy. This, you know, they gotta go big or go home.
So they say.
Joan Osborne. Yes, Drew. That's good poll. I'm not great with my 90s trivia. Whoa. Oh, yay.
What? Oh,
yep, that isn't still a definition of a thief, Cortana.
She's getting weirder.
Yeah, she said, I'm a thief, but. That implies some sort of qualification. No, that what you just said is what defines a thief. Also, yeah, Elena, back to your streaming solo stuff. It is hard. It is hard.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I have always streamed with some other person.
I did realize, I think, that I might have been talking a little too much during that first stream. That I went back and I started watching some other streamers.
Oh, we go down here, Wills.
Paid a little more attention. Okay. And it seems like, you know, you can kind of determine your own pace. You know, like...
Yeah,
you don't
especially
have to
a story-based game.
All the time. You can let people actually just be in the experience with you, right?
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, there's definitely a line. And it definitely depends on the game. I mean, that's why co-op games like this are always so fun to just chat with somebody. But yeah, I mean, if I was playing a story-based game...
Yeah. I did realize, though, that kind of like the same as with my dancing hobby. When you do it for fun, you're fully present. Once you start competing, you lose like 75% of your ability minimum. And it's like the same with streaming. So I'm talking so much that my ability to shoot things and figure out puzzles kind of goes down a drain hole.
Yeah. Yes. Hello, Fred. By the way, I do want to say I love that tense music that was happening right before this.
Yeah. Ring you destroyed.
When did you know?
Just now. But I had my hopes. What will you do?
Light it.
Light it.
We agree. A tactical pulse will completely eradicate the local infestation.
And everybody else.
I will personally oversee the final preparations. Though it will take time to...
How will you know?
Yep. We gotta go for Cortana, Willis.
What? Cortana?
We gotta go save her.
Cortana.
Fred, Halo 5 is already on PC. And Infinite will be coming day and date with PC as well. Well, we definitely didn't hit par time on that level. Whew.
Chief, I'll round up our survivors. Fall back to the dawn.
Speaking of part time, yeah. I was like struggle bus or whatever the term is these days. I'm so bad with the modern slang. I was having so much problems getting through the second to last mission in Halo 2 with Leif. Mm-hmm. I mean, partially it was that I was not bothering to actually coordinate with him and actually take advantage of the fact there was two of us, which is a whole different issue. I know, whole different issue. But at the end, when we finally finished, it showed us your guys' playthrough time.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, and it was like, yeah. Okay.
Your guys was like 20 minutes and we had taken like 30. And I was like, I'm just going to pretend they played on normal.
Well, real quick, Elena, are you in a place where you can join us? Because we just started a new level.
Still not yet.
Okay.
Sorry.
That's fine. No worries.
Thanks for asking, though.
Either way, thanks for being in here chatting. Okay. So we're back in some pulsing orifices.
Oh, boy.
So, yeah. Be careful where you step. Oh, here's a sword. Plasma sword as well if you need it.
Okay. If you want. Actually, where are you?
You gotta go up.
In the gala. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Coming up.
There you are. Yeah, here's a plasma sword right over here. Yeah, I do remember hating how, like, complicated it is to get around this level. Oh. Yeah, because I actually don't know where to go from here. Oh, I think we go back down. Or did we come from there? God damn it. I think we came from there. Do you see anywhere else?
No.
Maybe we are supposed to go back down.
Or is it through here?
I don't know. Yeah, this is where we've already been.
Okay.
Oh, I found an orifice. Oh, there we go. Yep. Down here, Willis, if you want to jump down.
Alright.
Just hold your nose and walk through here. Yep. Oh, she's close by.
Enemy, why have you come? I offer no forgiveness. The father's sins pass to his son.
Is Halo 5 on Steam? That is a great question. I don't know off the top of my head.
Halo 5, the standard game.
Yeah.
Not Halo Wars. I think Fred asked about that. But Halo 5 is not on PC yet, as far as I know.
At all?
No.
No.
I believe 6 is the first one that's supposed to come simultaneously to PC and Xbox at the same time.
Oh, I could have swore it did. Oh. Whoops, okay, well, I should have not have opened my mouth.
I thought you had said Infinite. Infinite is 6. Infinite's supposed to come simultaneously to Xbox and PC.
But I totally thought Halo 5 was already on PC.
Mm-mm.
Wrong. Adam, wrong.
Oh boy, I'm dead.
So once you're back in, Willis, there's a flamethrower up here, right?
Flamethrower?
Yeah, where'd it go?
I see it.
No, ooh. That's
That's a rocket launcher.
Oh, here's a flamethrower right there.
Ah, nice.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Come get some.
Whoa.
Nice.
Set that on fire. What? How? I died again.
Oh, no.
What happened?
I will tactically retreat.
I'm back.
All right.
Back.
Oh, you know what? I might as well do. No, I don't have enough. Well, maybe. Okay. I feel like I haven't dual wielded the SMGs enough in this playthrough. Dennis wants to know about our food preferences for after parties. Please, Dennis, real quick, can you specify after party? You mean like an event, like when we go to CES or something? Are you saying just like a social gathering? Okay, I'm back. I just want to clarify which after party. It's a little different based on the scenario. To the face! Yeah, I hate this level. I think it's
fireworks
good.
Pretty well.
Yeah, I know, right? new member in team, Adam Wrong. No, I'm the same old Adam who always gets everything wrong. Oh, yeah. All right, let's forge through.
Of course you came for her. We exist together now. Two corpses in one grave.
All right, so after party is in after lots of alcohol.
After lots of alcohol, huh?
You know, I mean... Thoughts and memories. Pizza. I love a damn good pizza, whether I'm sober or drunk. that'll probably be always be my like default. Like, call the pizza guy. Yeah, I'm gonna go with pizza.
Pizza?
Pizza's perfect
nice.
For every scenario.
Nice. What about you, Elena?
Elena gets drunk all the time.
I'm just wasted.
Yeah,
I'm
wasted right now.
I'm living the writer's life right here.
Yeah.
Just trying to be my own tech version of Hemingway.
Yep. Underpaid, overdrank.
overly saturated with alcohol. So are we talking about right after drinking or are we talking about the next morning?
No, it seems like that late at night while you
While you're still out with your friends.
Yeah, while you're still... It's the after, you know, the aftermath of you getting drunk with your friends.
Okay, so I think this depends on where you are, right? So, like, when I used to live in a small, more suburban area, the best you could do at that late hour was IHOP, which is not my favorite. But, I mean, when you only have one choice, you only have one choice. So there it was. I would say living in the city... I actually enjoy like late night Korean food.
Ooh, that's a good one.
Oh no, I can't respond to you.
Sometimes a burger, like a greasy burger, is good too to absorb some of the alcohol. I enjoy pho late night, but not when I'm drunk. It doesn't feel heavy enough, you know. So I tend to gravitate more towards heavier cuisine or like foods. When I've been drinking.
You've been to a pho place that opens late at night?
Yeah, there's like a place out in the Pitas that's open till like 3.
Oh,
and I think there's some places in the Tenderloin that might be open pretty late. Oh, I mean, obviously not now, but back in the day.
Back in my day, before we were on lockdown.
Ah, dead again. I got swarmed.
All right, backing up. Yeah, this I hate this level. I forgot. Yeah, pizza. I'll say when I was in high school or college.
Pizza is good, though.
Yeah, I would say the place we probably went to the most. Not necessarily my first pick, but the place we went to the most was Denny's. It was always it was just always too easy. There was a lot of Denny's where I was.
Denny's seems like a step below IHOP, at least in California. I'm not sure what it's like in other states.
It definitely depends on the Denny's, but I typically agree. I'm dead. And Dennis Sabrian says, pasta with egg salad, anyone?
Pasta with egg salad,
Ooh, no. That would make me
Listen, Dennis,
nauseated.
I think you're a cool guy, but I can't hang with that after. Nope. Yeah. If we ever get drunk together, I will not be joining you in pasta with egg salad. Also, is that something you make yourself, or are you getting it somewhere? It says, can you even have fried eggs or an omelet at 3 a.m.? Yeah.
In the U.S.? Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Also, IHOP, I mean, my go-to thing at an IHOP would be like a Belgian waffle. So.
Oh.
Yeah. That's what I would go for. If I was up at 3 a.m. drunk and hating myself. Oh man, I hate this area. All right, we need to be careful.
Yeah.
Need to be careful here. Dude, back off. Oh, and I'm down.
Okay, oh boy.
And Bryant, yes. The recommendations for Flight Simulator 2020 are crazy. Yeah. Oh, also the new Crysis. Yeah, I actually did pick up the new Crysis on my Switch, just so I could say Crysis runs on the Switch. I'm not going to say it's the version you want to play, but it's there. Oh my goodness, I'm down again. So Dennis says eggs are good at absorbing alcohol. When I'm drunk, I'm not thinking straight. I'm gonna believe you. I'm gonna assume that that's true, but yeah, I wouldn't be in a utilitarian state of mind to say, hey, you know what I need to do? I need to absorb this alcohol. I would say, you know what? I need to hate myself even further in the morning by eating a dozen donuts, if I could. Actually, I did that plenty too, eating lots of donuts when I was drunk.
Ooh, so Daniel Fatfingers says that the 101st Avian Soldiers prefer Waffle House in Clarksville, Tennessee, aka Clark's Vegas. You know, we don't have Waffle Houses out here on this side of the country. I would love to try it.
Well,
I have heard good things about it.
Yeah, Waffle House is in Phoenix. Waffle House is awesome.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay, let me rephrase that. As far as I know, there are no Waffle Houses in California, and I think also Oregon and Washington, but I don't think they're in California for sure.
Yeah, I think it's more of a regional. But Waffle House is awesome, especially the hash browns. Waffle House hash browns. Awesome hash browns.
I want hash browns now.
Oh, I killed myself. Back up.
Adam.
Tactical retreat.
Adam.
Okay, I'm back.
Okay.
All right, we're doing pretty good. We're doing pretty good.
I'm surprised no one said nachos or poutine for me in particular. Like anything
you
potato.
You said poutine?
Well, not. Well, at Berkeley, there's a few, or there was a few. Yeah, before this whole pandemic. But yeah,
were they open
poutine
late,
would have been nice. Yeah, as you know, with Berkeley in it's, you know, college town, so there's a ton of late night places open all the way until 3 a.m.
True.
Yeah.
Poutine's I guess I think of it as a little harder to eat. Same thing with nachos.
Oh, I don't know, man. Like, I don't think I could do nachos. Like, something about the texture while I'm drunk, I don't think would sit well in my stomach. But I would be willing to try poutine at least once. I just don't have anything like that on the side of the bay as far as I know.
Oh, come on. I just want this level to be over. I feel like the last level was so good, and then this one just kind of puts the brakes on it a little bit.
Anything that has to do with the flood. No.
I know, right? I think a skull was back here, right? No. Either way, I got a flamethrower.
Y'all have shotguns?
Yeah. They spawn us with shotguns.
How do they feel in this game? Because I feel like, so I've been playing Halo 2 with Leif, right?
Mm-hmm.
And there was a lot of flood in that last mission that we were struggling with. I felt like the shotgun was slower than in the first game.
Yeah, I don't like the feel of the shotgun.
I feel like they nerfed it slightly. But I wasn't sure if anyone else felt the same.
I mean, I would say it's It's not as good as the Halo 1 shotgun, that's for sure. It's better than the Halo 2 shotgun, but...
Mm. So you do think the Halo 2 shotgun is different than the Halo 1 shotgun?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, it wasn't just me, because I was like, man, like, the reload on this... The reload, or like, the time between shots is just taking so much time.
Oh, I'm down.
Okay, backing up. Backing up.
Okay, back.
I will say that this playing this level on Legendary by myself was not fun. Dennis wants to know our opinion on breakfast menus. I actually really like... I'm down still. I really like Taco Bell breakfast. Even though I don't like that them as a company, I Taco Bell breakfast.
Oh, man, down.
Burger King breakfast is my favorite. Yes. The little hash brown rounds, whatever they call them. Yeah. I like a good breakfast menu. And I prefer their croissants over McDonald's. Ready? Whoa.
Oh, my bad. Should have warned.
And our thoughts on the hubbub is... Whatever. It's going to be fun to play. I don't come to Halo for amazing top-level graphics. I come to Halo for the gameplay and the co-op. So, I thought it looked just fine.
I just show up to shoot things. I just show up to shoot things. That's what is all. That's really all what I expect from it.
Swarmed. Dead. Down. I'm back.
Okay.
I hate... All right. Get out of my face.
Daniel Fat Fingers. Yeah, California does have a lot of mom and pop breakfast cafes and you know, diners and stuff, but they're not late night. You know? So like if we're talking about the morning after where you're like, ooh, I probably should have had more water. then yeah, there's plenty of great places to eat for brunch. For like Sunday morning brunch, but for like late night, it's like stuck. 3 or 4 in the morning. You just want to hang out with people. There's actually not that many places open that late. Last
Korean,
call.
Is that, I was going to say. Sorry, go ahead.
I was going to say last call is like 2 a.m. in California, I think.
Yeah.
So.
And then the Korean shop, Korean mom and pops, or not necessarily mom and pop, but Korean. Like barbecue, or even just like a yeah, like a restaurant. They open up pretty late at night too.
That's why I like them. It's a little, yeah. It's a little bit. For me, it's not quite so heavy as you know an IHOP sausage.
Man, I'm down.
But
okay.
It's
Bojangles.
Heavy enough.
I've heard of Bojangles, but I've never been to Bojangles. Okay, I'm back. Nice. Yeah, and especially where I live, Alameda is not known for late night stuff either. There we go. Yeah, in my formative years of staying up really late and doing really dumb, mischievous stuff and then going and getting food afterward, I wasn't drinking at that point, but... That wasn't like a place I was. It was in Salt Lake City, so I wasn't known for awesome late night eateries either.
Patience, basking in new freedom. I will know all that I possess.
Okay, and that's what he said. Well, Dennis says, so Elena, where do you go at 3 a.m.?
I thought I covered this already. I go to a Korean place, or then if I have to, a diner, and then if I don't like either of those options, or if I haven't really been drinking, then I might hit up one of the late-night pho joints in our area.
Whoa, I am... What is happening here?
What's going on?
Man, I got like stuck. I couldn't back up. Okay, let's try that again. Once more into the sphincter. By the way, I will give a status update on that RK2020.
Grenade Elena.
Oh, you're down. I'm not going to make it. I'm not in a good spot.
This is tough.
Yeah. Let's see if I can get back through that sphincter. Oh, yeah, I can. Okay. There we go. Sweet. So the RK2020 does not play in 64 games that well. Spoilers.
Breaking my heart, man. You get my hopes up, and then you just crush them.
Like, performance-wise, it's definitely stuttery. Like, you know, it's like the PS1 was on the Pocket Go, where it's like, it's so close. The next version, it'll be smooth. Okay, I'm dead.
Oh, okay.
And there's a guy back by my body. Yeah. Sphincter. Enter the sphincter. Nice. But, yeah, the control thing is another thing, because... Some of them actually work pretty well. Like the, even though it's stuttery, I've been able to play a little bit of Ocarina of Time. And actually doesn't play too bad, control-wise. But then I tried to play GoldenEye, and for some reason, when you push forward on the...
I'm dead.
Okay. When you push forward on the thumbstick... It also, like, looks down, like there's almost, like, a momentum to it. So, like, you can't...
All right, back. Let's see.
Oh, you know what? Huh, I wonder if gyro is on? No. I should double-check that. Yeah. But it's just, like, anytime you push the stick forward to move forward, he, like, after time, he would just, like, run looking down. And, yeah, so that game was kind of unplayable. In the form, unless gyro was on or something, now that I'm thinking about it. Can't remember if that has gyro support. That would have been a problem. Oh, wow. I'm dead. You just hit me right in the face. There we go, okay.
And a Siberian said, in South Korea, you can actually buy food like ramen and cook and eat right in the store.
Yeah, like 7-Eleven.
Exactly, like the one you went to 7-Eleven in Taiwan.
Oh
like
yeah,
that.
I did. I did not dabble in like the steaming pot of weird things. Not that I was against it, but I. Yeah.
So
I didn't want to press my luck.
Eurocentric, quote unquote, weird things.
Well, I did. Well, some of those things in there, I don't know what they are. I knew there was eggs. Like,
they're
what were
so,
they
it's
called?
Familiar
like,
to somebody.
Isn't it like
that's what I'm saying.
Thousand-year eggs or something like that? Isn't that what they're called?
Those are Chinese, man.
Those are Chinese. I mean, you can still get it in Taiwan, but
yeah,
I don't think
they were
sell it
at
a 7-Eleven.
They were at 7-Eleven.
Really?
It was a big pot of eggs that were, yeah, really old.
Oh no,
black. Those are tea eggs.
Tea eggs.
Those are tea eggs. They smell so good.
They're delicious, man.
It's a very comforting smell. I love
I don't
that
know.
Smell.
Somebody had told me they were thousand-year eggs, and I was just
no,
like, mm,
no,
that
no,
name doesn't
no.
imply
thousand
anything
year
good.
Eggs, thousand-year eggs aren't made that way.
Oh, okay. I almost
at least
did try
that's
some.
That's not what I know.
It was funny. Late at night, I did see an exchange where an older gentleman came into whatever 7-Eleven or whatever the place was. I think it was. Or Family Mart, maybe. And was like... You could tell he was talking to the person at the thing, and they were like, yeah, go ahead. And so he just loaded up all the eggs that were left, you know, from the day into a bag. And, like, he must have got some... Like, I imagined it was, like, Gordon, you know, where Gordon, like, shows up, and he's like, hey, these are half off, right? And they were like, yeah, go for it. And then he's like, all right, well, I'm going to literally fill up this bag until I can't fill it up anymore with these eggs. And I was like... Dang, he must really love those eggs.
Oh,
kind of lost right now. Trying to find her again.
Okay. Oh yeah, you're kind of far.
Yeah. Hold on.
I'm surprised it didn't snap you.
Yeah.
Give
me 1 second.
So, I will say, you know, when you're looking at 7-Eleven and that big, you know, in Taiwan, and there's a big pot of stuff, you know, that's just been like sitting there cooking for a while. If I knew it was a meat product, I'd be like, okay, well, at least I know it belongs to the meat category. There was a lot of stuff in there that I was like, I don't know if that's meat. I don't know if that's a vegetable. I don't know if that's a root. I you know what? I'm not even going to take a risk.
Does it
without
matter?
Even knowing
Are you
the category.
Allergic? Are you allergic to vegetables and roots?
No, but I want at least a little bit of like, you know, be like, hey, prepared for something.
Why don't you just ask your host or the store clerk?
I was usually alone, and if I wasn't, I was with Gordon, and Gordon's like, yeah, whatever, just get eat it. And you know, he's like, it's cheap.
Eat it.
Eat it. It's cheap. And I'm like, I just want a little bit of a heads up. I'll try some weird stuff as long as I know what it is. It's not knowing what it is that I'm like, I'm going to take pause here for a second. And yeah, so that's my story. That's why I need Willis to go to, oh, I'm dead.
Oh, okay.
Oh, you're still back in this.
I'm still trying to find my way.
Oh yeah, so follow me.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're going to that sphincter over there.
Okay. Yeah, that's why I was excited. Like, you know, if we could have gone to Computex this year, you know, we could have taken you to the night market and test your palate, or at least enhance your palate to a little bit more.
Well, I did go to a night market.
You didn't try everything at the night market, I'm sure.
No, but I tried the most important one, though, at least. So I can check that off my list, and I don't have to do that again. Okay, so.
Or at least, what was it you tried that you didn't like?
The stinky tofu.
Oh, come on, Adam. Elena, help me out here. Do you like stinky tofu, Elena? Well, I forgot.
Willis, I have to admit, I am too American to be on your side of this camp.
Oh.
Sorry.
All right, anyone in the chat, back me up here.
I'm just saying.
Yeah,
also,
I tried
Rick,
it.
Rick Elder, we did say tea eggs.
Tea eggs, yeah.
This is not related to anything we're doing in-game, which may or may not be good sportsmanship.
I don't know, the Flood kind of look like little eggs with hairs.
Oh, jeez, you guys.
Yep. Continuing with these cryptic messages. All right.
Oh. All right.
Nice.
Rick Elder says, tofu isn't my friend. I like tofu.
Also, Daniel, this game is not very demanding. I'm running at 4K. You know, yeah. I even played it on eGPU with a 2070. Super. And I was able to stay 4K 60, locked 60, so.
So, Rick Elder, do you hate all textures of tofu? Because, you know, there's like the really silky, loose, soft kind, and then there's the super firm kind. So it's just like across the board, it's a no. Do you still have it?
The activation index from the first Halo ring. Little souvenir I hung on to, just in case. Got an escape plan?
Thought I'd try shooting my way out.
It's a good plan. Yeah, I like that.
So we found Cortana. Is she back with us?
She's back. She's back. There's two of us in our right. In our head. Well, my head, not yours. Okay, so now we gotta shoot our way back out where we came. We're literally going back to that first place that we found a flamethrower. Backtracking. Because we love this level so much.
Oh, man. Backtracking.
At last I see. The secret is revealed.
All right.
We need to buy some time. This reactor, start a chain reaction. Destroy High Charity.
Tea eggs. It makes them sound so much more pleasant than thousand-year eggs. Right?
Well, they're technically different.
I don't know, I'm just saying, dead. You know, you call 1,000 year eggs and you call one tea eggs. Like, I'm just like, oh, how cute, tea eggs. 1,000 year eggs is like, okay. There's a reason why that's called that. Whoops. God damn it. Didn't
but
mean
you
to
eat that. Fermented things, don't you, Adam?
I mean, I had stinky tofu, so yeah. Yeah, no, I totally would have tried it. I don't know. I was never in the right headspace when I came across it. So, yeah. When I go back to Taiwan and go to a 7-Eleven, I will definitely try the tea eggs. I was actually kind of bummed that I didn't.
One of these days.
One of these days. Just one of them days. All right, come on, sphincter. Open up. Don't shoot the sphincter. That's not nice. Oh, whoops. We're supposed to activate that thing over there. Spoilers for Game of Thrones. Gah. Just kidding. I've never seen it. Rick Elder says 1,000-year eggs are what Danny hatched in Game of Thrones. I think we're supposed to do something with these. Shoot this, maybe?
Oh, yep.
Yeah. Okay. You got the good gun to do that. Oh, it's not completely down. Oh, I just popped off the edge. Oh, kimchi, yeah. I like non-spicy kimchi. I know that might be sacrilege, but I like it when it's not spicy.
I have to agree with the sauerkraut versus kimchi thing, though. Because, like, kimchi is tart.
Mm.
And it has, like, a little bit more of a flavor profile, like, subtleties to it. I think especially because the spice is in there. Then you have sauerkraut, and it's just sour.
Yeah, I hate sour stuff.
Just one note, flat sour. I like sour too, but it's just a very bland, generic, flat sour.
Oops, I think I went the wrong way. Yeah, I did. Run, Willis, run!
Run?
Escape! Rip and tear your way through.
Ripping. Oh, and I'm dead.
Don't worry. I
run.
I'm just running.
Just run it. Gun it.
Running and gunning. Running and gunning. Running and gunning. I almost remember this path from the first time I played Halo.
Dennis Siberian, there are, like, restaurants that have, like, happy hour after 9 p.m., so I would usually go for that, too.
Oh, wrong way. Running and gunning. Ciao.
Wait, where did you go?
Don't worry, it'll snap you.
Oh, okay, I found it. Never mind.
Almost there. Sphincter, almost there. Sphincter. Running and gunning. Oh, I see it. I think I left you pretty far behind.
Maybe, maybe not. Let me see.
Oh, crap. Okay, yeah, I was about to say.
Nice.
Nice. Nice. Look at that.
Yay.
We did it. We beat Halo.
We did?
Oh, no, nice. I'm just kidding. We didn't.
We beat the Halo stage. Oh.
Yeah. I'm going to end us here. That's perfect timing.
All right.
Let's see. So next time we've got two levels. We got the last full level, Light the Ring, Destroy the Flood. And then we have the epilogue.
Wow, you guys powered through.
We just beat two levels. The Covenant and Cortana.
No, I just mean in general. I didn't realize you guys were already this far along.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice. Anyway, yeah. Cool. Then we will save the ending for yet another stream. I guess it'll be a part four.
Yep.
Let me look. Yep, we're on part three.
Hopefully join you then. We'll see.
Yeah. Thanks everyone for hanging out. That was fun. Willis, yeah. Are you excited?
I'm excited. Exactly, to finish this, and then we can get playing multiplayer. Hopefully we can get Brad to join us.
Yeah, multiplayer, and there's some other games I want to check out too. I talked about offline. I think we'll have a little bit of time before ODST comes out, so... Look forward to that. And then, yeah, tomorrow, for those who are still here, we got the next episode of The Full Nerd at 10:30 a.m. Pacific Daylight Time. We've got Ed Chrysler, I think is how you pronounce the name, from Sapphire. So we're going to talk about GPUs and gaming and all that fun stuff. So you should definitely pop in there and ask him what makes a GPU. Just kidding. We're going to go into a lot of fun stuff. I saw the questions ahead of time. It's going to be a good show. Anyway, thank you, everybody. Thank you, Dennis. Thank you, Rick. Thank you, Fred. But more importantly, thank you, Elena, and thank you, Willis, for hanging out.
Good times, as always.
Anytime.
Good times. And we will see everyone later. Accidentally started recording. That's not what I wanted to do. We'll see you later. Have a good rest of your Monday. Bye.
Bye.